What's up guys, Sal here. So as usual, the Galaxy S21 lineup will have two chipset configurations, Snapdragon 875 and Exynos 2100. And today we have benchmark scores of the Snapdragon variant, which the folks over the US, Canada and China will end up with. As you can see in Geekbench 5, it scores 1120 in single core and 3319 in multi-core, which is an improvement compared to Snapdragon 865, which had a single core score of 935. Since this chipset is still in the pre-production stage, expect the scores to be higher, but only marginally. Now, unlike the previous few years where the Exynos variant was flat out underperforming compared to its Snapdragon counterpart, Exynos 2100 on the other hand is, I would say, guaranteed to outperform the Snapdragon 875 because as per Ice Universe, the multi-core scores of the Exynos variant will touch or even surpass 4000 marks for the very first time. We have specifications of both Exynos 2100 and Snapdragon 875. And as we know, both of them will have identical CPU architecture, but is the clock speed where Exynos 2100 has Snapdragon beat this time? The Prime X1 core will reach 2.91 GHz in the Exynos 2100 while staying at 2.84 GHz in the Snapdragon 875. The trio of Cortex A78 units will differ even more significantly, 2.81 GHz versus 2.42 GHz. The 4 power efficient Cortex A55 cores will reach 1.8 GHz in Snapdragon 875 versus 2.21 GHz in the Exynos. This guarantees the Exynos 2100 will have more raw power compared to Snapdragon and thus will be the fastest mobile chip in the Android world. Of course, GPU will be a factor as well, but Huawei showcased with their Kirin 9000 chipset that the Mali G78 GPU is powerful and is actually 52% faster than Adreno on Snapdragon 865 Plus, which at the very least confirms the graphics on the Exynos 2100 will be the same as the one on the Snapdragon 875. In any case, Galaxy S21 will put an end to the misery of European and Asian customers who all these years were forced to pay high prices for inferior products. Ice Universe is saying the display on the Galaxy S21 Ultra will break multiple records. He didn't mention what exactly are those gonna be, but we already know a few of them. The first one is the peak brightness, which is 1600 nits compared to 1400 on the S20 Ultra. The contrast ratio is 3 million to 1 up from 2 million to 1 on the S20 Ultra for that beautiful blacks. Also the best display with Quad HD and 120Hz adaptive refresh rate. Maybe the most color accurate display as well, and more, we'll know soon enough. Ice Universe has obtained additional CAD schematics of the Galaxy S21 Ultra, and he says the chin and the side bezels on the S21 Ultra will be of the same size. In fact, he says the handset will have the narrowest chin we have ever seen on a mobile phone, even beating the likes of the latest iPhone 12 Pro Max. Here is a representation of how it will look in real life. It's actually photoshopped, the phone is upside down, but should give you an idea about the razor thin bezels. Of course, with that being said, let me know what you think about this down in the comments. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.